The Pleiadian Mission: A Time of Awareness, Part 18. The Contact's End. Once Billy's health had returned, there were only a couple of more contacts with Quetzal, and then on Thursday, October 19, 1978, the final meeting took place. There had been 115 contacts so far, and Billy had accumulated over 1,800 pages of contact notes for the people of Earth to learn from. He had done his best, but it had not been good enough. He had to agree with the council that it was time to end the contacts. He no longer had the strength to deal with all of the problems, and he had not turned out to be a strong enough leader to keep the F.I.G.U. in line. Billy left the ship that day for the last time. There would be telepathic communications in the future in order to see how he was, but the physical contacts for the purpose of education for the people of Earth were over. A new vision for Earth. My summer with Billy had opened up my mind to many things. But most importantly, it made me aware of how we need to work together to create our own future. It's one thing for the Pleiadians to come to Earth to help us out, but this is our planet and we have to take care of things for ourselves. I hope from what I have written in this book, you can find in yourself the need to help make the world a better place. We need to do something with as of this information. We need to study it and find ways to make it useful for our people and our planet. Peace is only going to come to Earth when we address the problems of our lives with spiritual understanding. It is time for us all to discover the spiritual bonding that connects all living things together with the creation. Once you can feel this bonding, you are in touch with power that can change anything. Imagine if, for just 1 hour, everyone on Earth bonded together and allowed their spirits to connect in love and understanding. In just that 1 hour, we could solve all of the problems that we have. This last chapter is for you and me. Perhaps here in the next few pages I can spark your thinking, and we can come together and find ways to rebuild our world and move into the next century as a peaceful and loving planet where we all can live to our fullest potential. Who knows, we might even get the neighbors to come and visit. Corning together in the Smithsonian Institute in Washington, D.C., there is a small glass case containing a rock from the moon. Each year millions of people crowd around the case and stare at the rock, taking pictures and spending hours in conversation about the excitement of outer space. This simple little piece of rock is not more than 2 inches long and looks no different from any small stone you would find in your backyard, but it's from the moon and carries with it all of the dreams and mystery of the biggest event in our history, contact with outer space. Those dreams are coming face to face with reality, for our contact with the Pleiadians provides us with new mind food to deal with. We have been given an opportunity to see ourselves through their eyes, a view of Earth as we really are, not as we think we are. But what do we do with all of these new ideas? How can we integrate what we are learning into our own society and help with the transition into the new age? Nothing is more important than to educate the minds of Earth about the material and the spiritual realm. People must learn to understand that they are more than just physical beings. We must help everyone get in touch with their spiritual self and feel the love of creation. This is the way we will break down the material forces of hatred, prejudice, and other forms of illogical thinking that put so much stress on our world. For us to make any progress in our quest toward a more enlightened planet, we must educate and wake everyone up to the spiritual side of life. Only then can we accomplish the transition into the new age with a level of higher consciousness. The Pleiadians and other races see us as spiritual beings in material bodies. They listen, observe, and study us as spiritual beings. If we are to take our place in the family of man throughout the universe, we have to clean up our thoughts and create a collective consciousness here on Earth of peace and love. If we continue to project thoughts of anger, jealousy, prejudice, hate, and other negative feelings, it will not be possible for us to communicate with the races of higher consciousness such as the Pleiadian. Time is running out for Earth, for our technology is pushing us out into space and right into the backyards of other races who are far more developed. We won't be able to take our systems of economics, religion, education, and government with us, for they will no longer be adequate in a more advanced universal community. The Pleiadians tell us that they can no longer defend us once we are capable of leaving our system under our own power, and that time is rapidly approaching. What are we going to do when older advanced races come to Earth who might like to conquer us, coerce our leaders into aligning with them for darker purposes, or worse yet, wipe us out and take the planet for themselves. The Earth will soon have its opportunity to align itself with peaceful races like the Pleiadians or with immoral races who would offer power and control to a handful of men on Earth to rule us. The people of Earth just come together with a common vision in order to make Earth a peaceful and loving planet as we move into the new age. We must overpower the greedy few who currently rule the planet with money and power and begin the transition from a material society to a more spiritual one. In order to do this, we must come together in a state of higher consciousness and align the power of our spirits with a common view of a new vision for Earth. By directing the spiritual power of thousands, even millions, of Earth people on a common vision, that thought can become a force of energy that can charge the world toward peace. Meditate on the following peaceful vision of Earth, and put power into it. Explain the vision to others and ask them to help out. If enough of us concentrate on the vision, our thoughts will create energy and cause the material world to give way to our force, and the planet will start to change. Remember, always start little things in motion to cause the big things to happen. Just like the creation, which started with a thought and created a universe, we can start with a thought and create a new world. Our future is up to us. The light workers of the New Age Earth is currently a planet of over 170 nations with as many different ideologies, philosophies, and social customs. The leaders of the New Age must find ways to bring these many different concepts and theories together and find the common denominator that will allow us to live together in peace. To begin with, we must learn to understand each other with an open mind that allows acceptance of other viewpoints, without anger and value judgments. This is a time of education for Earth. If you find yourself able to share knowledge with others who are on a quest of enlightenment, here are some suggestions that may help you communicate and be of help to others. A vision for Earth Blue, Blue Earth, your light is bright, shining through the Milky Way tonight, sending out a beam of love and riding high on a consciousness of living in the creation way, harmony with nature, in every way a world of peace where everyone can win a dream and love someone. And now you've moved through time and space to join the family of the human race, your life is rich, your spirit bright, and now forever you'll live in light. Find your own truth. Don't ask people to blindly accept your ideas or your information. Remind them that one man's knowledge is just another man's information. We must all earn knowledge for ourselves by experiencing it and making it part of our lives. Guide people to find truth for themselves. As questions are asked, try to answer only what is needed at the time. It is better for people to start with small bits of information and earn the next question through learning. All of life is a school, a spiritual experience of learning and growing. Knowledge is most useful if it comes at the right time. Try to promote the idea of an open mind. Not only is it a sign of intelligence, but it is the way to faster and more accurate learning. Promote integrity. Acceptance of new ideas comes from respect for those who offer them. If you project integrity and sincerity instead of ego or vanity, you will not only be of more help to others, but you will feel better about yourself. Don't exaggerate or say things to get attention or gain importance. Your spirit knows when you are being untruthful, you can't lie to yourself. The New Age is an exciting time filled with lots of new information and experiences, but we must be careful to be honest with each other and ourselves. There is no better way of feeling good about yourself than giving freely without expecting anything in return. If you want to fill your heart with love, simply give some to another, and it will come back to you. Role model. Our heroes in the last century have been captains of industry, movie stars, adventurers, athletes, musicians, and war heroes. There have been many fine people among those heroes, to be sure. But the attraction is usually that we see in these people that which we want for ourselves, a role model for how we would like to be. People learn by studying others. In happy homes, little boys want to be like their dads, and little girls want to grow up to be just like their moms. Role modeling is very important to our young and needs to be taken very seriously. In the new age, our heroes need to be of a different type. We need role modeling that projects wisdom, integrity, intelligence, and love. Let's use our schools, movies, books, and television to create heroes who are rich in values and honesty. The very fabric of our society is based on the integrity we instill in our young, for they create the future we will live in. Project Equality and Universal Love. Not enough can be said about the need for universal love in our thinking. Learn to see each other as spiritual beings on a path of growth and education, and sense the spiritual bonding that ties us all together. It is the material side of us that we find so much fault with. We are imperfect as material beings, but we are all logical and loving as spirits. If we are to eliminate prejudice, hate, and anger, we must educate everyone about the real meaning of life and the power of the spirit. If you share with each other as spiritual beings, your material heart will swell with love for one another. Learn to give of your heart and ask nothing in return, and you will gain the greatest gift one human can give another, the gift of love. The planet. It is time to consider the planet we live with as an equal part of creation. Although it does not have a consciousness as we do, it is comprised of particles of matter that have a life force. All matter in the universe is composed of energy generated from the evolution of creation, and should be respected as such. Get yourself on good terms with the planet and nature. Start by learning more about the planet itself as a hobby. You might want to study about the oceans, the forests, or volcanoes. Spend an afternoon watching birds build a nest, or sit down by a stream and talk to it. There are life forces in nature that you can communicate with. Sometimes called elementals, these beings of nature will let themselves be seen by humans if you are of the right consciousness. You can feel their presence and commune with them. It is a good idea to go for a walk every day for about 30 minutes with your shoes off. Not only can you feel the planet, but the pressure on the bottoms of your feet will stimulate the organs of your body and improve your health. This is an age-old practice called reflexology and can be a valuable part of your health care, so take a Saturday and lean about it. Keep pieces of rock, crystal, plants, and beautiful pictures of each around you. Give them names and make them your friends. Live with the planet, not just on it. Study spirit. Study about spiritual consciousness and share it with others. Read books, go to conferences, expos, and fill your mind with an inventory of information that can help you discover yourself. You might want to join or start a study group with others of like mind, and experience and learn together. Practice meditation as much as you can, for it's the gateway into your spirit and your older/higher self. Through meditation, you can develop more balanced thinking and make life more enjoyable. You can also try out your ideas and learn about the different levels of consciousness and how your mind works. Listen to those who have gone before you, and then find your own path and develop your own wisdom. Your life is your own journey and must be walked alone, but you can use the footsteps of another as a guide and make your own discoveries. Get in touch with creation and experience the spiritual bonding that we all share, and your material life will be forever easier and more fruitful. Then share it with another. Help educate the young. At any age, we are nothing more than the accumulated experiences that have gotten us to where we are now. And the experiences of our youth are the formative years that create our adulthood. Too many people are having difficulty with adult life because of childhood experiences that control their thinking. We must learn to educate our young better and eliminate child abuse. More than 50% of the children in America today are abused, either mentally or physically, by parents who don't love them or understand them. We are creating a nation of unhappy people who are not capable of offering anything to anyone else because of the hurt they carry around inside of themselves. Spend some time with children and help them with your love and understanding. If you can, adopt a child or be a big brother. You can certainly donate some time at a local park or school. Children respond very well to love and understanding, and so will you. Be creative. Creative thinking keeps you young and alert. It stimulates your brain and makes your spirit happy. The personal satisfaction that comes from being creative is a doorway to sharing your love with others. A beautiful picture you paint, a song, or a poem can project the love of your spirit to thousands of others and really make the world a better place. Art in any form should be promoted for everyone. Make it a regular part of your life. It's not important how good you are at it. The satisfaction comes from the process of creation, not the adulation of others. Shed the need for approval from others, and express yourself in art that brings out your unique qualities and helps you understand yourself better. You should at least keep your environment filled with music, paintings, beautiful crystals, books, and stimulating objects which challenge and stimulate your senses. Every now and then buy some object of technology that is beyond your present understanding, and just keep it around until you figure it out. It is important to teach your mind to constantly be learning and trying to grow to new levels of understanding. Remember, life is a school, enroll now. Who speaks for Earth as we think, our thoughts move through space. If millions of us combine our thoughts, we can communicate with other worlds and develop relationships with more advanced beings. In this way we can create alliance for Earth with peaceful races. This is very important, for the America government, as well as other first and second world nations, are all anxious to make connections with other worlds in order to gain power, weapons, and control over other nations. The dangerous game of King on the Mountain, played by the world powers, can lead us to alliances with non-human race who will offer technology and power in exchange for our lives. It is already happening in America, as certain above the law elements of our government have created alliances with a non-human race of ETs from a twin star system called Zeta Reticuli. It began in 1947 when one of their space ships crashed in New Mexico. The bodies of small non-human beings were discovered in the wreckage and gave our government a serious problem. Not knowing how to handle the sudden appearance of visitors from another world, especially non-human ones, and fearful of a panic, they decided to keep it quiet. A wise decision at the time, but within a short time more ships came and the administration was confronted with having to make a deal with these visitors. Our government decided to provide bases for the in exchange for technology. These small non-human beings, which are called Greys, have no emotional concern for us, and look at us as lab experiments. The Pleiadians have confirmed their existence, stating that they are a highly scientific race, more interested in the planet than in us, but on some occasions take Earth people for experiments. Over the years many Earth people have been contacted by these little Greys, but have learned very little about them. Earth is being contacted by the Pleiadians, the Greys, and several other races. Millions of people all over the world have seen their ships and have had contacts of various kinds. It is no longer a question of whether or not they are real, but a question of whether or not you know about them. The people of Earth need to make contact with the Pleiadians and other peaceful races, then we can be involved in how Earth becomes aligned with beings from other worlds. I feel that nothing is more important right now than educating everyone about their spiritual selves, and creating a large mass of humanity who can come together on the higher planes of consciousness and communicate with the Pleiadians and other peaceful races. The thoughts of Earth are being monitored all the time by many races. If they begin to detect a growing mass of people coming together spiritually, I believe they will come to our aid. Let's send greetings from the people of Earth, and not from any special branch of the government. Peace on Earth. It takes nothing more than watching the evening news to see how much trouble we are in as a planet. There are wars raging everywhere. The leaders of our planet are making no attempt to create peace because they stay in power through turmoil. No government wants to relinquish their own authority and blend in with other countries. This is why we have no real power in the United Nations. It is up to us, the people, to find a way to bring the nations of the world together, in spite of the governments. Imagine if we formed a group of spiritually minded people who understand and live by the principle of unconditional love, and visited different countries around the world. They could go to each major city and put on a spiritual education expo, where everyone shares and listens to one another and talks about our different customs, philosophies, and ideologies. By sharing, we can find the common ground between us and blend our heritages together in a common goal for our planet. We can carry the message of spiritual bonding all around the world. An educated mass of people can do far more than any government. There is nothing more powerful than 100 million people with common thinking and common goals. Look for ways to communicate and make this happen. You might want to join a computer bulletin board service and make friends around the world. It's the modern-day pen pal. Talk to people at embassies and send newsletters to organizations in different countries. Record audio and video tapes of your ideas and make them available to radio and television in other countries. Write, Or better yet, read a book about another culture. Find ways to communicate and understand people in other countries so that we can come together as a planet. People do not have trouble getting along, only politicians have that problem. It's time to educate, not legislate. I want to express my thanks to Billy and his family for extending me their courtesy and friendship during my 3 trips to their home. Even though they have endured so many hardships and difficult times over the years, they still had time to make me feel welcome. My thanks to Silvano, Bruni, Billy, Poppy, and the other members of the FIGU for providing me with the spiritual food to help me along the path of my own discovery. I hope that the information I have made available here in this book has in some way contributed to the ongoing efforts of the Pleiadian mission and is of benefit to mankind. I have no plans to return to Switzerland, but instead hope that the experiences of my travels can be of some benefit to other seekers of truth. Salome, Randolph Winters. Glossary. Seven Sisters is a term used by the Kiowa Indians to describe 7 Indian maidens who were put in the heavens by the Great Spirit to escape the advancement of a bear. The 7 sisters became known as the star cluster called the Pleiades. Absolutum is a term to describe a large body of creational energy that contains billions of universes. Ours is one of them. Adam. In the old language of Lyra, it means earth human being. A Lyran scientist named Sinjasa created an Adam, or Earth Human, through genetic engineering, which started the story of Adam and Eve. Age of Aquarius. A time period of 2,155 years as the Earth moves through the constellation of Aquarius, one of the 12 constellations. Also called the Age of the Water Bearer. Age of Waterman. The same as the Age of Aquarius. Used to describe the period that the Earth passes through the constellation of Aquarius. Agartha is an ancient underground city built in the Gobi Desert under the gigantic city of Mu around 33,000 years ago. There were 2 cities, called Agartha Alpha and Agartha Beta, that were connected by an underground tunnel. Mu was destroyed, but Agartha still exists today. Akashic. In Eastern philosophy, the term Akashic means the same as etheric and refers to the unseen energy of thought that is stored in a ring around the planet. The Akashic is a storehouse of thoughts from the past that can be accessed through meditation. In India, it is regarded as including material and non-material entities in a common medium. Sometimes referred to as the Akashic Records. Android is a synthetic or artificial creation made to resemble the human form. It is used for the purpose of serving man in many different forms. Andromeda Galaxy is a large spiral galaxy that can be seen from Earth. It is similar in shape and form to the Milky Way galaxy that we live in. It is 2.2 million light years from Earth and is 160,000 light years wide. It is the home of a very advanced race of beings that provide advice to the Pleiadians and other races. Andromeda is a constellation in the Milky Way that supports human life as we know it. Beings from there have visited Earth on occasion. Arahat Athersada is a spiritual entity that no longer exists in material form but exists in pure spiritual form and is comprised of 7 different spirits. It was the teacher of Jesus Christ that also telepathically sent information to Earth at the request of the Pleiadians to Billy Meyer in the 1970s. Arahat Mountain is a very large mountain in eastern Turkey. Believed to be the resting place of Noah's Ark, this religious mountain has special meaning to many religions and belief systems. Aramaic is the language that was spoken in the days of Jesus Christ. His teachings were written down in Aramaic and were discovered in 1963 by a Greek priest. Armenia is an ancient culture that originally lived in the region known as Armenia in northeastern Turkey. Today most Armenians live in Russia. Armis people. In the year 8104 BC, the Great War between Atlantis and Mu left the world largely uninhabited. One of the 3 surviving tribes were the descendants of the people who lived in an area known as Armenia 33,000 years ago. They were called the Armis people. Aura is a field of energy that surrounds a human being. It is magnetic in nature and can be seen using Kirlian photography. It appears in colors which reflect the thinking of the human mind. Ba'fath is a race of extraterrestrials who are the descendants of ancient Lyrans. They were forced to leave Earth over 10,000 years ago, but but returned and hid under the Great Pyramid of Giza in Egypt and fought to gain control of Earth. The Pleiadians removed them from Earth, and they are no longer a threat to us. Barnard Star is located just 4.4 light years from Earth. This star has two planets in orbit around it that have supported human life in the past and possibly still does. Barter is a form of trade that does not require money. Before our current system of money, most of the world engaged in trading their products and services in this system called barter. Beam drive is one of the two drive systems used on a Pleiadian beam ship to propel it. A beam drive is a system that creates energy by converting light into power. It is an older system and is no longer being manufactured. Beam ship. On Earth we call round flying discs from other worlds flying saucers. The Pleiadians call their ships beam ships, after the drive system that powers them. Beta Centauri is located only 4.3 light years from Earth. The planets around this star have been home to human races in the past. Big Bang. Many Earth scientists believe the universe we live in was created by a Big Bang of energy that exploded and pushed itself out, creating the formation of the galaxies that currently exist. Boomerang is when we create thoughts in our mind, they speed out into the universe. At a certain distance they change polarity and return to the center. This process is called the boomerang. Capricorn is one of the 12 constellations that the Earth passes through every 25,860 years. We are now in the age of Aquarius, Capricorn is next. Caspian Sea, the world's largest inland sea. It lies between Europe and Asia. The south coast belongs to Iran, while the rest of the sea is surrounded by the territory of the USSR. Central Sun is in the center of our galaxy. There is a large ball of energy that provides life-giving rays to the entire galaxy. It is called the central or universal sun by many. Central universe, the Pleiadians are aware of three types of universes that are evolving within the original creation, which is called the absolutum. A central universe is the highest order that they have discovered, but its function is still a mystery to them. Changing belt is one of the seven belts of energy that divides up our universe. The changing belt is a non-material area that is responsible for the conversion of energy into other forms. Channeling is the process of entering a meditative trance in order to call forth other entities which may use your body to speak. Cheops. Cheops was a pharaoh in Egypt and is sometimes thought of as the builder of the Great Pyramid. It is also called the Great Pyramid of Giza, which refers to the Giza Plateau on which it is built. Coarse matter is the energy that is in the solid state of matter, as opposed to fine matter, which is energy in non-material forms such as thought. Codex. The codex is a form of karmic debt that many Earth people live under because of their previous lives as Lyrans who ravaged the Earth. It is the spiritual awareness of owing a debt to humanity for atrocities done in previous lives. Cognition is when knowledge becomes part of the individual. It is called cognition. Coherent. That which is logically connected, consistent as a coherent argument. Consciousness is the formation of rational thoughts. The human being has a material consciousness and a subconsciousness, which are both capable of producing a collection of thoughts we call consciousness. Constellation is the Earth and all of our solar system travel in a large oval pattern which takes 25,860 years to complete. This time period is divided into 12 sections which are called constellations, as in Virgo, Aquarius, etc. Creation. This is the spiritual energy that had the idea to create the universe that we live in. It is a spiritual form that contains the eternal energy of life and knowledge that rules all things. Creational universe. This is a type of universe that creates a material belt of planets, stars, and life forms in order to evolve. The universe we live in is a creational one. Cuneiform. This is an ancient form of writing that was used by the Babylonians, Persians, and others. Its characters are in the form of wedges, and are slim, triangular shapes that form into a language. Tao universe. This is the universe that is right next to ours. It is a creational universe, like ours is, and supports human life. The Pleiadians are in touch with a race of humans from their call timers, pronounced Timers. Dead Sea Scrolls is a collection of ancient manuscripts discovered in a cave in the cliffs at Qumran, Jordan in 1947. The writings date back to 200 BC, and largely reconstruct the Old Testament and the long-lost books of the Apocrypha, and the books of Enoch, Jubilees, and the testaments of the 12 patriarchs. Dematerialize. The Pleiadians have a high technology which allows them to convert their ships into a non-material form. The process is called dematerializing. Depolarize. Is the process of reversing the magnetic pole of something. For instance, you can depolarize a magnet by changing the polarity of its poles from positive to negative and vice versa. Destroyer comet is a large comet that passes by Earth approximately every 575 years. It has been the cause of much destruction on Earth as well as many other worlds. It was the cause of the biblical flood in 8104 BC, Devil's Tower. Is located in Wyoming. This large mound of Earth is a sacred site of historical importance to the Kiowa Indians. They believe that seven Kiowa Indian maidens were being chased by a bear. The bear tried to catch the maidens and left his claw marks on the side of the tower, which is evident when you see it. The Great Spirit intervened and put the seven maidens up in the sky as stars, which are called the Pleiades. DNA deoxyribonucleic acid is the main carrier of genetic information in all living organisms, except viruses, that contain ribonucleic acid. Easter Island is located 300 miles off the coast of South America. This island is covered with strange monuments carved in stone. The monuments were images created of extraterrestrials led by a man named Viraco Koha, who supplied the tools to the local people to make the statues. Ego is the I, or self, of any person. Egotism or conceit or self-important etheric in India, etheric is used to describe the unseen energy and thoughts of humans. It comes from the word ether. It is sometimes also called the Akashic. Eva? This is a Lyran word which means earth female. It is used in reference to the earth female that was coupled with the Adam, or earth human being, that created the story of Adam and Eve. Fauna is the animals of a given region or period considered as a whole. F.I.G.U. is a German acronym for Free Community of Interest of Border and Spiritual Scientists and Ufologists. The F.I.G.U. is a special group of people who have banded together to help Billy Meyer disseminate his Pleiadian information to the world. Fine matter is the energy in non-material forms such as thought. Flashing refers to the flashing of the mind as impulses are sent from the conscious mind to the subconscious in order to create a thought. The rapid process occurs millions of times per second to create thoughts. Flora is the plant life of a region or period. Refers to the food kingdom of Earth. Fluffy matter. During the evolution of energy into matter, fluffy matter is the term used to describe the state of evolution between thought and gas. Gabriel. Gabriel was a Pleiadian man who was the father of Emmanuel, or Jesus Christ. The moot is the sensory connection to creation that is within all of us that connects our spiritual self to the infinite creational energy. Genetics is the science of heredity, dealing with the resemblance and differences of related organisms resulting from the interaction of their genes and the environment. Giza Pyramid. Sometimes called the Great Pyramid or Pyramid of Cheops, the Giza Pyramid was built on what is called the Giza Plateau, which is just outside of Cairo in Egypt. Gobi Desert is a large desert located in Mongolia. It was the home of the great city of Mu, which was built around 33,000 years ago. Great Time is a unit of time measurement which describes the complete cycle of a creation from the time it has the idea to create a universe, the creation of one, and then the collapse back into itself to sleep. One great time amounts to 311 trillion 40 billion years by our calendar. Heat dissolving beams. A term used to describe the awesome power used by the beam ships of Atlantis. These beams of energy were capable of dissolving matter and leaving no trace. Hebrons or Hebrews. A band of people who survived the Great Holocaust of 8104 BC, Hesperides. This planet was a refuge for human life that escaped the great wars in Lyra. Higher Self. As life forms, we are both material and spiritual beings. Higher self refers to the consciousness of our spiritual self that is generally more knowledgeable than our material consciousness. It is higher in wisdom, intelligence, etc. Homo sapiens is the species of bipedal primates to which humans belong. Hyades is a planet which supports human life forms that escaped from the Great Wars on Lyra and made it their own home. It is not known if life still exists there. Hyperborea is a colony founded on Earth over 15,000 years ago in the area that is now called Florida. Hyperboreans live underground and are believed to be now living under Mount Shasta in Northern California. Hyperspace is one of the dimensions of our universe that is outside of the three-dimensional existence we live in that makes travel at high speeds possible. PLEIADIAN beam ships enter hyperspace to cross the large distant S of the universe in part of a second. Ideologies is the body of doctrine, myth, belief, etc. that guides individual, social movement, or group. Ishrish is a female who has become a king of wisdom. To have obtained total knowledge of the material existence of the human being. Ishwish is a male who has become a king of wisdom. To have obtained total knowledge of the material existence of the human being. Emmanuel is a great prophet of his time who taught the lessons of creation. His father was a Pleiadian man named Gabriel, and his mother, Mary, was of Lyran descent. His teachings were adopted by the Catholic Church. They changed his name to Jesus Christ in the year 189 AD. Karmic is taken from the word karma, thought of as bringing upon oneself inevitable results, good or bad, either in this life or in a reincarnation. Kashmir is a large valley which stretches across the northern tip of India. The Valley of Kashmir is administered partly by India, partly by Pakistan, and partly by China. Considered to be a spiritual area for many religious 255 leaders. Kilometer is a unit of measure. 1 kilometer equals 0.6 of a mile. 100 kilometers equals 62 miles. Kiowa is a race of Indians who inhabited the area of North Dakota until around 1800. It is believed that 7 Kiowa Indian maidens were put into the sky and became the star cluster known as the Pleiades. Listen is a small planet of unknown position in the cosmos. It is the home of an ancient spirit form that was brought to Earth by the Pleiadians to assist with their mission to help man. Light year is a unit of measure to indicate the distance that light travel in 1 year's time. Light travels at 186,000 miles in a second, and 5,865,696,000,000 miles in a year. Lotus position is a sitting position where the individual crosses the legs in a certain way during meditation. Lyra is the home of the human race that populated Earth. Lyra is a star constellation. Madagascar is a large island located off the southwest coast of Africa. This area has the same mysterious effects as the Bermuda Triangle. Mayan calendar is an ancient prophetic calendar left by a race of people called Mayans who lived in central Mexico. Their predictions have been preserved down through the ages on what is called the Mayan calendar. The Pleiadians believe that the information on this calendar is very accurate. Mecca is located on the Red Sea. This town is the spiritual capital of the Muslim Empire. Every day millions of Muslims get down on their knees and face the city of Mecca and say their prayers. Milky Way is a name given to the galaxy that we live in. If you look up in the sky on a clear night towards the direction of the center of our galaxy, you can see millions of stars that appear in a milky, cloud-like formation, which has led to the name the Milky Way. Melona is the ancient ancestors of Lyra founded colonies on 3 planets in our solar system, Earth, Mars, and Melona, a planet that was in orbit past Mars. Is a violent war destroyed Melona, and all that is left is the debris that we now call the asteroid belt. Mothership is a large spacecraft built by the Pleiadians. It houses over 140,000 passengers and provides them with all the comforts of a planet. Smaller ships can dock in it when visiting and hitch a ride to other parts of the universe. Mount Shasta is located in Northern California. Mount Shasta is the home of the descendants of a race of people called Hyperboreans. Their ships are golden color and can be seen sometimes entering the mountain on the northeast side. Mu is an ancient city which was founded in the Gobi Desert around 33,009 years ago. Its founder was a man named Muris, who was the father-in-law of Atlant, the founder of Atlantis. Mu became an empire, with satellite cities all over Earth. The empire was sometimes called Lemuria. Nazca is located in South America, high up in the Andes Mountains. This area has large lines dug into the ground that have mystified science. Under the lines are electronic sensors planted there thousands of years ago by the Andromedans. New Age is a term used to describe the time period which signifies the beginning of the Age of Aquarius, which started February 3, 1937. Nizzle Bodies is a small organelles in the human body which contain the spiritual self of the human being. Null Time is outside of the three-dimensional world we live in, is an area of the universe where time is almost non-existent. This area is referred to as null time, meaning no time exists there. It is also referred to as hyperspace. Orion is a constellation located 444 light-years from Earth. It is also the home of human life that descended from ancient Lyra. Oscillations. All matter is made up of particles that are constantly in a spinning motion called oscillating. Other side. The Pleiadians refer to the other side as a place where spirits go after the material life is over. It is a band of energy which surrounds the Earth and is commonly referred to as heaven. Paradigms is a phrase used to describe a set form of knowledge that serves as a model or pattern. A model of thinking. Part second is a phrase to describe a small unit of time. The Pleiadians refer to time as being pulses of energy that cause the rotation, movement, and animation of matter. 1 second of time is divided into millions of small parts. Part second, then, is an expression meaning one small pulse of time in a second. Patale is the highest form of consciousness before becoming one with the creation. The Patale level is a collection of many consciousnesses that no longer have individual awareness. Pharaoh. In Egyptian, the word means great house, or royal palace. Also used to designate the reigning king of Egypt. Pictographic is an old form of language used by the Babylonians, Persians, and others to leave behind their story in picture form. Pisces is one of the 12 constellations that Earth passes through. We have just left the age of Pisces and are now in the age of Aquarius. Pleia system is the original home of the Pleiadians, was called the Osiel system after its founder. His daughter's name was Pleia and assumed power after his death. From then on, the system was called the Pleiades. Pleiades is a small cluster of stars located in the constellation of Taurus the Bull. It is 500 light years from Earth and is the home of a race of humans who frequently visit the Earth. We have common ancestry with them. Procreated is a translation of a Pleiadian word which means to cause someone to be born, as in procreating their spirit into material life. Psychic, pertaining to the human soul or mind. Mental, not physical. Outside of natural or scientific knowledge. Sometimes used to refer to a person who is allegedly sensitive to psychic influences or forces. Push belt is the outer edge of a universe that serves as a protective shield. It blocks out energies from other universes and protects us. Real-time vision is a thought that comes into your mind from an outside source that is indistinguishable from reality. The vision occurs in real time, meaning that a 10-minute idea takes 10 minutes to come into your mind. Rematerialize is a high technology of the Pleiadians to cause the material form of their beamships to become coarse matter, or solid. The process of returning from dematerialization. They can dematerialize their ships and then rematerialize them at will. Ring Nebulae of Lyra is located in the constellation of Lyra. There is a large ring in space which is the remains of a sun that was exploded during a violent war there. It can be seen by astronomers through powerful telescopes. Rosicrucians, a secret society started in the 17th century. They claim to have various forms of occult knowledge and power and profess esoteric principles of religion. Sanskrit scrolls are ancient writings of the Indians in India dating back 10,000 years, which carry the truth about life and creation. To modern science, they only date back to around 1200 BC, Sirius the Dog Star. It is the brightest appearing star in the heavens and is located in the constellation Canis Major. Human life from there migrated to Earth around 33,000 years ago. It is believed that Sirius is the home of the black-skinned race. Sohar. When the universe was being formed, there was a great blast of energy, which established the area where the universe would form. This blast of spiritual energy is called the Sohar. Sol system. Refers to a sun that has planets orbiting around it. Spirit. Is the same as the soul. The Pleiadians refer to our souls as spirit forms because they are formed from the original creational energy of the creation, which they called spirit energy. We are spirit forms from that energy. Spirit form. The same as a spirit or soul. Creation is the ultimate source of spiritual energy that is referred to as spirit. Humans are a form of spirit that are still connected to creation, but have their own consciousness called spirits or spirit forms. Srinagar. Is a town in India that was the home of Emmanuel after the crucifixion. He lived there until he died and is buried somewhere outside of the town on the side of a hill. Srinagar is located in the very north of India in the area that passes through the valley of Kashmir. Supernova. When a sun reaches old age, it suddenly becomes thousands of times brighter, and then gradually fades to its original intensity. Synagogues. Places of worship for the Jewish people. Tachyons? Is a small particle that travels faster than light. It can be detected in our own three-dimensional world. Taygeta. Is one of the seven stars of the Pleiades. It is the solar sun for the Pleiadians, who live on the four planets that are in orbit around it. Telekinesis. Is a spiritual power that enables you to move objects with the power of your own spirit. Telemeter ship. Is a small reconnaissance ships built by the Pleiadians which are used to gather information on Earth. They can be as small as a basketball or up to 9 feet in diameter. Telepathy. Is the power of the human spirit to receive and send thoughts to another human. The material mind as well as the spiritual self both has methods of telepathy. Thought form. Means the same as a thought. Timeless. Is a part of our universe that does not contain the energy of time. Pleiadian beamships commonly use this timeless area to speed through light years, while time stands still in normal space. Timers. Is a race of human life that is in contact with the Pleiadians in order to help the human races. Their home is in an adjacent universe called the Dao universe. This is the first and primary spiritual force of the original creation and is responsible for creating timelessness in new creations. Universe. An Ur-universe is one that creates creational universes. It has no material belt, but is all spiritual energy. It evolves into a central universe. Van Allen belt. Is either of two regions of high-energy charged particles surrounding the Earth. The inner region has an altitude of 2,000 miles, while the outer region is between 9,000 to 12,000 miles. Vega. Is a star that is the home for some of the descendants of the ancient Lyrans. We form. Refers to a special sense within all human life that is the sensor for the ability of telepathy. There is a material we form and a spiritual we form. Zeta Reticuli. Is a twin, or binary, star system that is the home of small non-human beings that visit the Earth. We call these visitors little gray, or Zetas. Are alien spices who sometimes abduct humans for experiments and have no emotional attachment to us. Zeus. Is the mythical Greek god that ruled over the heavens. About the of this book. Randolph Winters has been investigating the UFO phenomena for over 15 years and is considered one of the foremost experts in the field. He is the founder of the Pleiades Project, a special interest group formed in 1987 to study the UFO contacts of Billy Meyer. The focus of the Pleiades Project has been to disseminate the Pleiadian information given to Billy Meyer to the general public through lectures, tapes and books. In 1988, Randolph made a one-hour videotape called The Pleiadian Connection, which covers the Billy Meyer contacts. The video contains over 120 beautiful clear daytime photos of the Pleiadian crafts and gives a general overview of the entire case. He is also a contributing editor for UFO Library magazine and writes regular features on the Pleiadian UFO case. His unique insights and informative discourse have become a regular feature in the internationally distributed magazine. Randolph has appeared on an NBC News special on UFOs and spoken on radio talk shows as well as numerous television interviews. He was the creator of the first UFO Expo in Los Angeles as well he has lectured at the Whole Life Expo, UFO Expo West and many other UFO conferences around America and Europe. Considered an authority on the Pleiadian case, his lectures always proved to be both informative and entertaining. This is the end of Part 18 and the last part of the Pleiadian Mission, A Time of Awareness. For more information, please visit thepleiadianmission.com. Again, visit thepleiadianmission.com. Thank you for listening. We hope that this information was somehow useful to you. Remember that knowledge is power. Don't be left in the dark. Also subscribe and share this video. Let the whole world know the truth. Bye bye now.